the course ready? This one, huh? So please click on the new course that's been assigned to you. Open your blended course design document. All of you, please, you have that with you? Pen drive. Here it's there. So please change this to activity chooser. We want to use the latest in the administration block. Click on this activity chooser so that you'll get whatever. Yeah. First step is you need to add your course title. What's the first step for that? Just now we did embed the video. So how do we do that? We need to change the title. Add the course title. This is blank. In the general area, click on this gear icon. No, not here, here. Course title. You align this to center. You open the first button. Click on the first button so that all the, yes. You type in your course title. Yours is international? Yeah. So this is actual course development. We have started now. Please, all of you. Are you on your smart UMS? What is it? No, no. One new course has been assigned to you. Go to my courses. Not this one. Go to my courses. What's the new course title you have given? Click on that. What's your course? Yeah, that is good quality. What about you? I don't know. What's your title? Course title. Subject. Oh, click on that. No, no, no. Actual course development we are doing. No need to import anything. This is actual course development. Yeah, click on the gear icon in the general area. And follow this. So add this title, your course title. Here we are supposed to embed your course video. Okay, the new course. You select this text, select the text, and go to this formatting option, that is the second button, and choose heading 1. If you want to add color, some color to this, you can select this and select a color. Or if you want to retain black, you can retain black. Okay. And if you don't add your contact details in your video, you are supposed to share that your on this general area. Just hit enter and embed video. Just that's instruction for you. Write it down. Embed course introductory video. Then hit enter. Facilitator contact details. You change that to heading style 3 or 2 something. Yeah. Okay. And you can enlarge this full screen. Last button. You just toggle between full screen. So that you'll get wider area. The last button. This one. Yeah, you show them. You can toggle between full screen and all. Yeah. Click on that so that you will get wider area. Now you write down your name, your email address, your phone number. If you are giving your phone number, within brackets you also mention contact timings. Otherwise student will bother you like anything. 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. or 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Okay. Your email ID. Do you have a web page? All of you? Yes or no? What is this? No, no, on your UMS website, you don't have your faculty profile pages, you don't have? Yeah, we'll hyperlink that. Yeah, we'll hyperlink that. Please share your email and your mobile number. Faculty profile page is updated, everyone. It's an updated profile page. No, it's updated. They update frequently. Okay. So please go to your faculty profile page and copy that link, and we'll hyperlink so that your students will get to know more about you. All of you go and get the URL from your UMS site. So what are the additional information available or details available here? So any additional information other than that? Okay, areas of expertise, all of that. Click on one thing. Tell me. Okay. Please copy the URL of your profile page. Come back to your course page. I want to hyperlink this with my name. How do I do that? Select, and on the first row you have, don't click it. Insert link option is there. Please click on that and paste your URL. And change this, wait, target page to new window blank. So that I can retain my students on my course page, it will pop up in a new window. Click on insert. Do you want to share your course handout or syllabus? Generally you do that? You have course in Synapsis. So here you can hit enter. Download the course in Synapsis from here. You highlight the word here and insert the link. You can upload from your PC or laptop. Click here to download the course outline. Click given. So more clarity. Click here. Start with click here. Everything. So you highlight, you select the word here and go to insert link and upload this. For uploading, wait. Are you on the same screen, all of you? We are uploading the course synopsis or outline or syllabus. Are you on the same page? Are re-demonstration required? Please tell us. I'm cursing. Your students will also do the same. They'll never open up their mouth and say, yes, sir. Are you on the same screen? Shall we proceed? Okay. Then click on this so that we'll get the file picker. So we call it as file. Please remember that you are going to take up the role of mentor or master trainers. So use as far as possible Moodle terminology. We call this as file picker. Okay. So on the file picker, these all are options. Click on upload a file. By default, it's showing that only. And choose the file from your PC or laptop and attach that to the link. Do you have that?
I have my.
You don't have that pen drive? Yeah, please get that. You don't have your course outline or Synapsis course handout? Huh? You don't have? It's been listed out in the preparatory workshop prerequisites. What did you do then? Or if you have same on your website, you can download and upload. Do you have that on your website?
No. Previous.
directly you can upload, no? Directly you can upload. Choose file and go to that drive, yes. From there you can upload. No need to copy. So now we are linking up your course outline. In the general area, you are supposed to do this for every course. Insert. So it's been attached with the word here. Are you done with this step? So here we have provided this, and you click here to download the course outline, and we have selected here. You please select here. And then the first row, you have, once you select this, it will be activated, insert link, and pick up the file. Yeah, insert the link. And if you want to get that link from here, you just click on this and on upload. This is the file picker. Click on upload a file if you are not there. Choose a file and pick up the course outline file from your PC or laptop and open. And upload this file. Cancel. So not required. We have already uploaded. And one more thing. If you, yeah, you select this. If your file is available elsewhere, say for example on Google Drive, that directly you can paste the URL here. You know how to get the share link from your Google Drive or any drive. Directly you can paste. Oh, either ways you can do that. You have. Yeah. Then you can cancel this. You can cancel and you unlink this. Unlink button is also there. Yeah, now we are demonstrating how to get a file from Google Drive. Okay. Select here. And as always, click on the button insert link. You get your Google Drive URL. How do you get that? Go to Google Drive and copy that URL first. Open a new tab. I think you are already there, no? Go to you. Yes. Go to drive.com. You will get that. As far as possible, try to upload your files on any external repository. Don't overload your server. Either Google Drive or OneDrive or Box or Dropbox. Okay? You also encourage your students to do the same. So how do I get that URL, that share link? Now from the top three also you get the share link, no? From there you get that now share link? Yeah. No, not required. Not required. That is for sharing. Yeah. You can simply copy this. Yeah, paste it here. Now save it. Now on Google Drive. Go back. Yeah, go back. So where is your file? Which file? Yeah, if you right click on this, you get the share link also, no? Yeah. This way also you can directly get the shareable link and copy it on that, okay? No need to, okay. Can view, that's just, more than enough for students. Can view. Okay. So Google for education. That's view permissions are already there, no?
Yeah, that's why you should tell your students only login using their email.
Gmail, that to UMS Gmail, not their personal Gmail. So it's a restricted among this only, no? Yeah. Or else you can simply upload the file from your PC. The first way we did, no? Yeah, you minimize this by toggle full screen. Toggle full screen, toggle full screen. No, no, no. Toggle full screen button. Last button. Then only you'll be able to see the save changes button. So once you embed your video, then you'll get this all this here. So this is the actual course page you are going to develop. Are you done with this part, first part? This will come under one of your 1732 course over here. Okay. For sharing resources, course synapses.
You have to do that, otherwise the system does not detect that as once. Then when you use the lecture page, they are recording because the system looks for that thing.
Okay.
So we edit up, but we still use this.
Okay, then you use this. Course synapses, you are supposed to use this. For sharing, but sharing file will not come under 7. This is only course overview, that's it. It will not come under 7. Sorry. This is not any learning resource or learning content. It's a PDF file, course overview. Introduction of course and course video and everything we want, that's it. It will not come under 7. But whereas, as you said, why can't we use file options instead of course synapses? Is it mandatory? You have something back? Oh. Okay. So, this is exclusively for, I don't know that, okay. So, for uploading your course syllabus, don't use that hyperlinking the text. You just use this. Yes. So, if they want to monitor, audit will be there, it seems. So, better use this. Now, you will use this and upload. You do that then. Please, all of you use this course synapses module and upload that. No need of description, you can simply drag and drop, scroll down and scroll down further. You can simply drag and drop or click on this arrow and using the file picker you can upload. Only PDF file. This is what you have been following, it seems. Okay. Scroll down and save.
Pages.
You need to mention the pages, the
because
number of pages.
Only display one or two pages.
One and last
so,
page.
Sometimes we have 11 pages, so we need to mention
problem.
One to 11.
Yeah, that's the problem with
the last page. Like
so, we
page
have, we just read 1 to 11.
That's the problem with that. Yeah, for some reason, when we our synopsis may be 4 or 6 pages containing all the student that entire, but when you upload,
you better do both ways.
So here we have two ways of doing this, linking it up with the text and uploading the file using your course synapses module. But it's mandatory, it seems. Okay?